5月31日至6月2日，第13届中国中部投资贸易博览会在湖南长沙举行。本届博览会吸引了来自32个国家和地区的1000余家企业参展，200多家跨国公司参会。记者了解到，中国中部地区受到越来越多外资的青睐，不少参会的跨国企业表示，计划加快在中部地区的投资布局。活动期间，塞尔维亚工商会主席顾问安娜·斯托扬诺维奇率代表团来到湖南，参访了当地企业，并将在绿色能源和可持续发展等领域与湖南展开合作。他表示，中国中部地区交通条件良好，区位优势明显，民众购买力持续增强，消费市场潜力强劲。为了与其更好地进行贸易往来，塞尔维亚在湖南设立了工商会代表处。
Actually, China is one of the main economic partners of Serbia, and recently in October 2023, our two countries signed a free trade agreement, that will come into effect at the 1st July, and we think that we will open doors for many companies to boost the trade and investment. And I am very pleased to say that we already had cooperation with Hunan province, with Jinjiajie, Bulin, Huan. In collaboration with them, we entered on this market for the first time with the Serbian ice cream, also with our wine. And we think that this is just the start of a very good future cooperation.
上海美国商会会长郑毅指出，以湖南为代表的中国中部地区省份，如今在经济水平、产业基础和创新能力上都有了很大提高，或将成为外企新的布局方向。
东部因为它比较发达，我们已经做了很多的布局，那下一步要做什么呢？我觉得中部是一个很值得看一下。首先我觉得从成本角度，无论从土地来讲，从人工，包括它的一些技术的能力，制造业、装备业，都有一些特色。从湖南来讲，它的政府对投资环境非常重视。我觉得一个市场对外资是否有吸引力，它的营商环境，它的这个软实力是很重要，外资还是很看好这样的一个对外资比较有吸引力的这么一个环境。
在英中商业发展中心主席约翰·麦克莱恩看来，中国中部地区是外资企业投资创业的新天地，他很乐意将英国企业引进来，为双方经济发展做出贡献。
Significantly, China has changed because it is far more entrepreneurial. It wants to look at things in a different way. I welcome this opportunity because I think whether it be in industry, whether it be in education, whether it be in tourism, whether it be in sustainability, climate change, there are significant numbers of opportunities for us to develop. And we all know that for business,to succeed, you've got to have relationships, you've got to meet, you've got to chat, you've got to understand each other. So anything that we can do that promotes exchange by way of tourism, cultural exchanges, engagement makes sense.